This dissertation explores contemporary debates on portrayal of addiction on screen, arguing that modern TV shows aren't to blame for the glamorization of drug use on screen. To demonstrate this argument, I will be conducting a case study into Euphoria, a show released by HBO that conveys strong statements about drug addiction and abuse.
What is it?
No idea.
Didn't you just get out of rehab?
Yeah.
Should I be concerned?
Maybe.
One of my main arguments will surround the influence of screening this media to the younger generation, who could be more susceptible to engage in risky behaviours within their own lives. Secondly, I will investigate the impact of social media on the consumption of the show, arguing that glamorisation comes from external factors that are out of the show's control. In chapter one of my research, I aim to focus on a scientific study that analyses social media posts, specifically Reddit, that surrounds controversial topics displayed in Euphoria. Breaking this chapter down, I will be discussing how social media has become a huge factor to Euphoria's viral success, and how that has affected the accessibility of the show to viewers who don't fall under the show's MPA rating, 18+. Furthermore, I will also explore the idea of media effect and how different types of viewers could be affected by Euphoria's content in different ways, subconsciously and consciously. This exploration will help me demonstrate the overall argument, as it proves how audiences may hold differing opinions about sensitive topics due to their own beliefs and opinions. For chapter two of the study, I will be discussing the genre of teen drama and why the topic of substance abuse was important to Euphoria's creator, Sam Levinson. I will then explore an early 2000s teen drama production, Dawson's Creek, discussing how substance abuse was approached and displayed to its younger viewers back then in comparison to modern TV dramas today. This will help highlight the different approaches producers have taken since the development of social media and the internet to represent the topic of addiction. Moving on to chapter 3 of exploration, I intend to use descriptive analysis of the script, cinematography, and editing styles of the show, which will spark a deep exploration into the supporting arguments that Euphoria intends to educate rather than glamorize. My focus will link back to the cultivation theory, exploring scenes from the show that connote the changing relationship between characters, especially in relation to identity and community. The cultivation theory is the idea that the more television people watch, the more likely they are to hold a view of reality that is closer to television's depiction of reality. This theory will be relevant to demonstrate my argument, as it could prove that Euphoria is trying to change audiences' stereotypical views surrounding addiction by showing the harsh reality. What's more, this chapter will also build on ongoing debates conducted by DARE, Drug Abuse Resistance Education, who accuse Euphoria of choosing to misguide and glorify and depict student drug use, addiction, violence, and other destructive behaviours in negative lights. These opinions have then been critiqued in many modern articles, evidencing the lack of consensus regarding the impact and significance of these representations. The scenes I will be analysing in this chapter is in the second episode of the first season, where Rue is forced to take a substance in a tense standoff with a dealer. The tone and dialogue of this scene supports the idea that the use of substances isn't always for fun, and the scene also depicts what dangerous situations you can find yourself in when seeking drugs. I will also be analysing scenes that display the highs and lows of an addiction, such as the walking on wall scene after Rue takes drugs at a party, and the scene where she verbally abuses her dealer for refusing to sell her drugs out of friendship. Overall, my research's aim is to establish to what extent these claims can be validated, and if producers are mitigating their show to represent addiction as a real-life issue. I'll be exploring both sides to this argument and come to my own conclusions once analysing my case study. To determine to what extent Euphoria does glamorise drug use on screen to the younger generation, in this chapter, I will be discussing a study that explores drug and alcohol dependence and its relation to the expanding world of social media. This will be important for this argument, as it will highlight that social media could be more responsible for the glamorization of drugs in Euphoria. The study's main objective was to examine Reddit posts made by Euphoria's viewers to identify themes that resonate with adolescents and teens, to determine whether they had negative or positive opinions of the show and its coverage of sensitive topics. The study used a long and reliable mathematical method to filter out all comments and posts that didn't correspond to its thesis, and eventually found out that the themes that resonated most when discussing Euphoria were social media, addiction, and mental health. Just from the objective, social media is a new factor that comes into play when researching addiction issues among the new wave of adolescents. However, when it comes to the topic of addiction, there are many factors that come into play, and different viewers could hold opposing opinions to each other due to their personal experience. Many participants of the study believed that Euphoria depicted addiction very well, whilst others believed it was still too much. The discussion surrounding the depiction of substance abuse on screen will be helpful later in my dissertation in Chapter 3 scene analysis of Euphoria's most sensitive scenes, such as the walking on wall scene and the scene where Rue is going through addiction withdrawals, to talk about the highs and lows of addiction displayed in the show. However, before we discuss opinions about Euphoria from the study, it's important we analyse how audience may form these opinions and why they may not always be a reliable viewpoint. Media effects is a theory that refers to the many ways individuals and society may be influenced by media. Selectivity exposure is the idea that individuals tend to favour information which reinforces their pre-existing views, while actively avoiding contradictory information. This theory is useful for my study, as it is possible that the viewers of Euphoria will hold different views on substance abuse on screen due to each individual only retaining information that supports their moral views. People only attend to a limited number of messages out of the constellation of messages that can potentially attract their attention, resulting in multiple viewpoints and opinions forming over the same media content. In theory, viewers who haven't been warned of the dangers that come with drugs could find that the show glamorizes drugs, as they would not pick up on the self-destructive paths drugs can take you down. For example, an audience member could completely disregard Rue's overdose scene and instead only recall the scene where Mandy and Cassie took MDMA to have fun at a carnival. The messages an audience member selects would have the potential to influence them, meaning that audience member could view drug taking as a fun activity to pass time with friends. This would then in turn influence that viewer to try it for themselves. Viewers that do favour the more distressing scenes involving drugs would be the complete opposite, being influenced to stay away from that sort of lifestyle. Another media effect theory which could be relevant to this study is the hypodermic needle theory, which was developed in the 1920s after researchers observed the effect of propaganda during World War I. This theory suggests that media messages are injected directly into the brains of a passive audience, suggesting that audiences all respond to media messages in the same way. However, researchers in the 1930s discovered limitations with the model. Although I believe the basic principles still apply, it was just underdeveloped at the time. When dealing with diffused audiences, there is never a simple answer to predict how a viewer will interpret information you are giving out. A theory that possibly develops on from the hypodermic needle theory is arguably the encoding and decoding theory presented by Stuart Hall in 1973. Hall's theory describes how producers use various signs to encode a program's meaning, which is then decoded by viewers who must interpret the message through their own understanding and knowledge. This in turn suggests that no matter what the intended viewing experience was set out to be, every viewer has the possibility to experience a different takeaway meaning due to the knowledge they acquire on the topics brought up on the screen. With this theory in mind, it would make it extremely difficult to blame a specific TV show for glamorization when the accusation could just be supported by a sector of audience that interpreted the media differently. If TV isn't the factor that could primarily encourage the glamorisation of substance abuse, what other factors are in the running? Therefore, in this section of the chapter, I will be researching into social media's effect on the issue at hand. The National Institute on Drug Abuse claims that the most used substances among 13 to 18 year olds are alcohol, marijuana, hallucinogens, and ecstasy. They also discovered that the use of marijuana and hallucinogens between the age ranges of 19 to 30 has increased significantly compared to any other year. These stats have reached historic highs in this age group since 1988, and with social media being the obvious change in this generation, the question still stands whether these scientific discoveries can be linked to its development. The rest of this chapter will engage with scholarly debates that link this increase to the development of social media, such as TikTok and Twitter. Coming together via social media has definitely made it easier for audiences to discuss their shared interests. Reddit is a platform where people can connect and discuss their areas of interest, including TV shows like Euphoria. However, media audiences have become more fragmented and dispersed since the rise of social media, meaning it is harder for broadcasters to anticipate who is exposed to their show and under what conditions. Euphoria is rated TVMA, meaning the show is only suitable for viewers over the age of 18. The release of the show became a whirlwind across social media, primarily on YouTube and TikTok, with trends being set in fashion, calling the show's costumes and makeup the new aesthetic. Though this social media exposure doesn't explicitly promote substance use, it does decontextualize scenes within the show involving drugs, only showing positive consequences. Across TikTok, characters such as Cassie and Maddie were glamorized for their clothing and makeup by young teens, as the most common way teens express themselves and identify themselves is with their style. The show aims to realistically portray elements of a public health crisis through its characters and theme. However, characters that don't struggle with drug addiction in Euphoria have enticed many underage viewers to access the mature content purely for the glamorous outfits and lifestyle. According to the uses and gratifications theory of Bulmer and Katz, people consume media to fulfill certain desires. One of those desires is the need to find our own personal identity through observing other people. Without the education that addiction is a disease, these naive viewers may relate drug taking to forming that desired identity, resulting in experimentation at a young age. I will be discussing who should be responsible for this education in more detail in chapter 3. The National Institute on Drug Abuse found that individuals who began using addictive substances before the age of 15 were 7 times more likely to develop a substance abuse disorder than those who first used at the age of 21. This means that the consequences of ignoring the maturity rating of the show could possibly be detrimental to a young person's development into adulthood. Potentially, the show itself doesn't glamorize substance abuse, social media and underage viewership does. Within the genre of teenage dramas, substance abuse is always a topic that arises, mostly used as a character arc or a gateway for a party scene to escalate with the help of alcohol. One study sponsored by the Office of National Drug Control Policy found that illicit drugs were seen in almost 20% of episodes of teenage dramas studied, and alcohol in 77%. With teenage dramas being one of the most popular and upcoming genres and primarily consumed by younger viewers, it is essential that the depiction of drug use should not be glamorized due to the younger demographic that engages with these shows. As Euphoria is an extremely popular teenage drama series, the creator of the show, Sam Levinson, ensured to uphold this responsibility due to his personal experience with addiction as an adolescent. At his lowest point into his struggle with addiction, Levinson described being disturbed at his actions, explaining to journalists, "It really spooked me in the sense that if I were to die today, who would I be?" Levinson then channeled his negative experience of drugs through the protagonist, Rue. In Rue's more shockingly violent moments, such as wielding a shard of glass at her own mother or emotionally manipulating her younger sister, Levinson used these scenes to represent the unspoken shame that comes from these episodes of emotional distress amongst addicts. It also represents how drugs can tarnish relationships and the respect others may have for you. These negative connotations surrounding the use of drugs then reinforces the point that Euphoria isn't glamorizing drug use, yet trying to educate an audience on the feeling of being misunderstood. Many viewers would relate to this feeling, and many others don't. The viewers who have not felt this feeling may possibly find it harder to overlook the distressing scenes to see the bigger picture of the intentions behind the chaos. Fauria has a producer that has experienced the struggles of addiction, who knows the damage of glamorising drug use in their work. But what representation did addicts have in the early 2000s of teenage dramas? An early 2000s show that I will be discussing in this section of the chapter will be Dawson's Creek, airing from 1998 to 2003. Specifically, I will be discussing an episode which aired on the 8th of November, year 2000, called Great Expectations. This episode's plotline surrounds a group of friends going to a rave, where a character called Andy decides to take ecstasy for the first time. When discussing the pill with another character called Jen, Jen raves about the drug to Andy, exclaiming that it made her happy and gave her a vacation from her problems. However, following those statements, Jen also confided in Andy that the drug made her more depressed afterwards and left her no longer knowing who she even was. Ignoring Jen's warning, Andy took the drugs without Jen's knowledge later in the episode, regardless of the consequences, as Andy's intention was to have fun on a night out. Eventually, Andy collapses and is taken to hospital after her medication reacted badly with the foreign drug. Jen was then being ridiculed by her peers for supplying her the drug. In this scenario, Jen is a former addict to ecstasy, so it is reasonable to question as to why she would encourage her naive friend to try the detrimental substance in the first place. Furthermore, Andy was warned of the danger, yet chose to escape her problems instead of ignoring the peer pressure. It is not anyone's job to control what paths others choose to go down, and regarding the representation of an addict, I believe the show has approached the issue realistically. Jen was honest about the consequences and wasn't pressuring Andy to take anything she didn't want to. Arguably, I believe the show represented addicts negatively by insinuating that it was the addict's fault for Andy's actions. However, I do believe the overall message of the episode remains a positive influence for curious teens to not experiment with unknown drugs without being in a safe space. Overall, it is possible that both shows use tragic scenes and storylines about substance abuse as a shock tactic to discourage teens from experimenting in the first place. This idea is questionable, however, as it has been argued that shock tactics don't work in advertisement. However, adverts are short and bonds with characters aren't made through a 30-second interval. TV, however, audience connect to the characters' lives and relate them within their own. This emotional connection would then make more of an impact to a viewer when the character comes in harm's way, causing reflection on how they would have avoided the danger if they were in the character's shoes. Moving on, that brings us on to the last chapter of this study. I will now explore scenes within Euphoria that reinforce the argument that social media decimates negative opinions surrounding the show in relation to the glamorization of drugs. As previously mentioned in this study, the cultivation theory supports the idea that audiences can have differing perceptions and depictions of the same stressing scene, in turn resulting in skewed debates whether Euphoria is too distressing to view. The first scene I'll be discussing connotes the dangerous situations that an addict can find themselves in when actively seeking out drugs. The scene from season 1, episode 2, consists of the main character Rue showing up unannounced at her dealer's door in a manic state. The tone of her character displays a lack of awareness to others around her as she continues to disregard Fez's wishes for her to leave his house.
I'm out of drugs, so...
But that's not my fucking problem. You gotta get up out of my house right now before these motherfuckers come through.
Dialogue used within this warning, such as motherfuckers, connotes a dislike for the characters in question and alludes to an audience that the meeting is not for pleasure, but necessity.
Now, when Fez said his dudes were coming over, I didn't think his dude would be this dude.
Sam Levickson once told Variety, anytime you put anything on screen, you run the risk of glamorizing it, just by the nature of it being on screen. He then went on to say he didn't intend to be triggering and just wanted to be authentic in his work. This could be the approach Levinson took within this scene, displaying a naivety of Rue's character to connote to an audience that when tampering in the world of drugs, you aren't as invincible as you may feel in comparison to criminal drug offenders. Therefore, within this scene, Levinson depicts the influence of those in positions of power
to be much greater than those who supply drugs to ordinary adolescents. They run a business that reigns in the threat of violence. When the cartel leader in question, Mouse, does arrive, he immediately fixates on the young vulnerable girl seeking drugs, possibly as he enjoys the power that comes of being the supplier for those who are desperately trying to escape their reality. Inappropriately, he forces Rue to try a drug called fentanyl while stroking her thighs uncomfortably and demanding extra money. Fentanyl is considered more potent than heroin and is tied to many cases of overdose. The use of this potent drug, mixed with the pressure of maintaining everyone's safety within the scene, showcases a great example as to why drug taking is never worth the risk of losing your dignity, or even worse, your life. Consequently, this could reinforce the argument that TV shows aren't to blame for being insensitive in relation to the glamorization of drug use. Following the premiere of the first season of Euphoria, scenes containing intense drug use sparked many concerns among anti-drug associations, such as DARE, Drug Abuse Resistance Education, and the Parents Television and Media Council. DARE was an anti-drug program which began in 1983 as part of the Reagan Just Say No era. They taught children knowledge surrounding the dangers of drugs to keep them on a safe path. In relation to the study, DARE shared a statement with TMZ claiming that Euphoria chooses to misguidedly glorify and horrendously depict drug use as common and widespread in today's world. The Parents Television and Media Council also agreed, by using the statement, chooses to misguidedly glorify, DARE chooses to put the show in a box that suggests that Euphoria was created with the purpose to harm its viewers. In relation to the cultivation theory, when receiving feedback from an outdated anti-drug association on a modern TV show all about hard drug use, a negative response is most likely expected. DARE's values and beliefs as an association would impact the messages they choose to interpret, completely disregarding the messages for representation and awareness of addicts. For example, the walking on wall scene in the first episode of the season consists of Rue snorting a substance, then when she leaves the room, the corridor around her starts rotating, causing the addict to fall recklessly down the walls. Isolating this scene, I would agree that the cinematography does make the shot look fun and exciting, which could glamorize drugs for that split second, agreeing with DARE's statement. However, in the very same episode, the audience is shown a montage of Rue's previous overdose, as well as her distraught family in the hospital with her as a result. The tone of the characters within this montage is bittersweet, with Rue seeming happily unfazed by her actions, whilst her family is worried beyond belief. Despite the statements, even DARE would most likely agree that premiering an overdose certainly isn't choosing to misguidedly glorify drugs. What's more, the show was rated TVMA for a reason, meaning that calling it a threat to the well-being of children is unfair, as children are not the target audience for the show. Furthermore, it should be the parents' responsibility to monitor their child's internet access or streaming access if such a threat is recognised. The only way a child would get access to mature content like Euphoria is arguably through social media. Therefore, by ensuring parental controls are activated, there should be no threat of drug glorification on the children. Overall, the show wasn't designed to appeal to everyone, yet it is important to know that it was not made to be a pretty glamorising show. In conclusion, there is not enough evidence to suggest that Euphoria glorifies drug use across social media. The storyline surrounding drugs is primarily focused on the main character Rue, and is used as a technique to represent the struggles of an addict while simultaneously trying to discourage those invested in her character arc from taking drugs themselves. Additionally, the content from the show that was shared widely across social media among teens were the scenes that promoted style and individual identity that had no relation to the abuse of substances. However, there definitely is still a risk that comes with the development of social media and the glorification of negative behaviours. TV's purpose is to depict reality to create a fictional reality, and creating that reality will most likely involve characters participating in risky behaviours to develop the storyline. It's the responsibility of the guardian of a child to monitor their internet access if there are concerns for negative influence. This influence is recognised by producers before the release and is thus the reason for the mature age rating of the show. Furthermore, risky behaviours such as drug use and violence are alluded to at the start of any TV production, warning that if that topic is known to be triggering for a viewer, not to continue viewing. Social media can only be controlled to a certain extent, meaning to avoid the younger generation being misled by distressing scenes, education should be taught on topics such as violence, sex, and drugs, whether that be in school or at home. Overall, the way in which shows are disseminated across social media does not glorify substance abuse. The approaches during production and distribution impact the glamorization of the given TV show when filming sensitive material for mass consumption. Thank you for watching, and I hope you have enjoyed this study and have learned not to take drugs.